We've had several guests on for the past several weeks discussing how businesses can tap into their ideal markets and reach their target audience effectively. And the main reason why I did that is because failure to target your proper audience and to market to them and message them, communicate with them correctly, believe it or not, is the number one reason why most businesses fail. It's not lack of cash flow. I know a lot of people think that is the case, but believe it or not, when you do a lot of the research, it's the failure to tap into that target market or target audience. Today, I have with me on the show, I'm using his full name, John Peter Mahoney, also known as Johnny Irish, the CEO of Social Media 305 that is based in South Florida. John really does an outstanding job of working with people to have a major impact in their message and broadcasting it using social media. And so, John, are you there?
I am. Good morning.
Oh, good morning. I'm so elated to have you on. I've been working with John on several projects, and he's just got the greatest energy. And he's got an incredible personality. He also has been a radio personality in the South Florida market. So I'm just ecstatic to have you on today, John. You have an incredible background, and it's a very unusual background compared to a lot of people who are actually in marketing and in particular in the social media space. And so can you share with the listening audience a little bit more about you and how you created Social Media 305?
Absolutely. It's my honor, and thank you again for the opportunity to speak here today and be on your show. It's awesome.
You know, thank you.
Long-time listener, first-time caller. I guess you could say I was kind of always in sales and marketing since I was a little kid, you know, with paper routes and, you know, cookies and school chocolate sales, stuff like that. But what happened was, and really, I think where we were able to separate ourselves from the rest in regards to social media was I worked on Wall Street. And in my career on Wall Street was 100% sales. It wasn't about trading stock. It was about raising money, finding a qualified lead, developing that relationship, and, you know, keeping that for as long as you can and raise as many millions of dollars as you can from clients around the country using the telephone. And in 2008, when the market cracked, I had been in the market, you know, going on 15 years, and I reached the point where, you know what, I've seen enough. Life is too short to spend it living on the telephone. So, ironically enough, I've spent the last 10 years living on the computer, you know? But what happened was, social media was, I don't want to say it was a game, but initially I hadn't considered it. I hadn't thought about it. I was just at home watching the stock market, watching trades, and it was something to do during the day while we're trading. And on the financial side, I linked up with some serious traders from around the world. Guys that work for big banks out of London, heavy traders coming out of Spain at nighttime. Everyone I dealt with was in Australia, and it just clicked one day. I said, this is where the leads are. I said, you can reach anybody you want using Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, nowadays Instagram, whatever the platform is. And it had yet to really come about. It wasn't saturated, kind of like it is today. You know, 10 years ago, your local restaurant didn't have a Twitter account. At most, they had a Yelp page that they weren't even watching. You know, they probably Right. didn't even know it existed. So what happened was I started hosting events, and I started telling local businesses, you know, the people are here, they're talking about you. And on the flip side, I was able to get into an industry, public relations and marketing and advertising specifically, that without social media, I probably never would have been involved with. If I was, I would have had to start at the bottom and work in an office and, you know, do another 80-hour work week trying to be, you know, the daddy of the advertising industry. And Twitter specifically gave me the opportunity to get inside all these A-plus offices, deal with the magazines, deal with the public relations firms, sports stars, whoever it might be. If you had a Twitter account, I was knocking on your door with a quick good morning, it's going to be a beautiful day tweet. And it went from there. And it